Ontario recently launched an online portal seeking to recruit more healthcare workers to help in the battle against the COVID-19 crisis. One of the nurses working until recently in an Ontario hospital is Filipino nurse Christine Joyce Vega. But her work permit expired last February, and when she tried to extend it at the Canada-US border, she instead got a deportation order because she missed paying a $100 fee.
That triggered an exclusion order, which meant she was to be scheduled for removal as quickly as possible. And so there was some negotiation, but they settled on a removal for 28th of this month.
Vega asked McRae to help her. McRae challenged the exclusion order and submitted a temporary resident permit application for Vega. He also asked Canada Border Services Agency to defer Vega's deportation.
We shouldn't be deporting a nurse in the midst of a pandemic.
When Filipino-Canadians in BC learned of Vega's plight, community leader Narima De La Cruz acted to help stop Vega's deportation. De La Cruz got in touch with several members of parliament, including the MP in Vega's riding in King Vaughan, Ontario.
I just thought there would still be something that can be done just with the proper connection and the right person to talk to.
Within days of De La Cruz's email, MP Debbie Schultz reached out to Immigration Canada and the deportation order was lifted. McRae said Vega was very happy with the decision and wanted to go back to work in the ICU as soon as possible. He added that the actions made by De La Cruz and Vega's MP certainly helped in getting the order lifted.
I'm very grateful for how quickly the government responded to this particular situation, and I have to think that the one thing that made a big difference is people reaching out and letting the government know that this is not a decision that makes sense, particularly in these circumstances.
Vega also has a pending application for permanent residency in Canada. Rowena Papasin, ABS-CBN News, Vancouver.